Snake, we got lots of
get over here.
Never.
I was going to hold one, but I got to facilitate this interview.
Yeah. Sure.
I was thinking of everybody else. I am.
Those
are intertwined.
Those two like each other.
Here, you'd hold that.
Oh.
Jim, you get the angriest one of the bunch. Good job.
Good.
There we go.
Ooh. Okay, so it's Creature Feature, where we have Jason from Shell Factory come in, and he brought a snake for the whole team.
Yeah.
So these are ball pythons. They're native to Africa. Jim, you have that's the natural coloration in the wild.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
And the rest of these are, through breeding and genetics, breeders have created these color morphs.
Really? I mean, Anissa's is really, really pretty. It matches your outfit, Anissa.
Right. We were meant to be best friends.
That's amazing. And this one, that was found in the wild?
Yeah, Fish and Wildlife. Wow. Somebody had found it, called them, and they came and got it, and it really had nowhere to go, so we gave it a home.
Now, we notice it has a very thick tail.
Right in there.
Yeah, he probably just ate, I don't feed him, but he probably just ate a small rat a couple days ago.
Oh. So he's probably in a good mood at least.
Yeah.
Interesting. And these are all, I mean, they are very different colors, but all the same species.
Yep, they're all ball pythons. Yep.
I think the ones Jen is holding, they're very pretty.
They are pretty.
They're probably one of the most popular pet snakes, and there's so many, even more than this, there's so many more color variations and patterns out there.
It's amazing. So this one that I have that's getting frisky here, this was a pet?
Yep, we just got that one a couple days ago. And, you know, they only get about 5 feet full grown, so they're not a large snake.
Mm-hmm.
But you do have to handle them a lot to keep them kind of tame.
Okay. So we don't know if this one's tame or not.
It's pretty good.
Good to know.
It seems to be experimental.
Yeah. That's how it goes.
So far, so good. Why do people tend to turn these in? They don't get as big as the ones we see in the Everglades.
They don't. I think people, you know, it's an impulse buy. They are kind of cute when they're little. They only get 5 feet, so it's not like you're managing a Burmese python or an anaconda or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I think people just get tired of them.
I got it.
And it can be a little expensive to feed. You know, the rats and mice aren't cheap.
Really?
Well, yeah, I can imagine.
What do they do that makes you so tired of them? Aside just sit in a cage.
Yeah, right? I mean, they're pretty... They're very low maintenance pet, really.
Yeah. I mean, but you think the one that was found in the wild was just dropped off by somebody?
This one wouldn't last long in the wild because he has no camouflage.
Right.
He couldn't have been out there very long because something would have picked him off.
His markings are very fascinating with the head.
Is so cool.
It right? is amazing. Yeah.
So and these are constrictors, right?
Yes.
They
grab and then they wrap around and squeeze their prey.
Mm-hmm. Nice. and they definitely do that. Some of them more than others.
And they're called them. None of them are really doing it right now, but they're called a ball python because one of their defenses, other than biting, is they literally just curl up in a ball.
Yeah. Oh, same.
I thought it was because they're having so much fun.
These are. How many do you have? I know you have a lot of different species.
This is all of.
There.
This is all the ball pythons we have. We have actually just yesterday. A red-tailed boa had 15 babies live birth.
Oh, wow.
Congratulations.
Craig, you weren't there.
That's,
one more push, Mom.
Yeah. And you do have all kinds of different reptiles, too, and a lot of them are, most of them are former rescues.
We have spiders, scorpions, bugs, snakes, lizards, a little bit of everything.
Well, we talk a lot about it, and actually, Anne, your manager, and you and I were talking that a lot of people mistake the Shell Factory as a zoo. It is not. It's an animal rescue.
It's a rescue, sanctuary, refuge. These animals, a zoo would not take,
because
you see some of the birds don't have all their feathers,
right.
Things like that. A zoo kind of wants perfect animals, so these animals really would have nowhere else to go.
And so a lot of people do get the exotics and think it's going to be a great idea, and then it's not.
Yeah.
they're loud or difficult, and so that's how you end up with so many of them. But what's cool is you get an opportunity to see them up close. And
You're a little bit more closer to a lot of our animals than you are at a zoo.
It is really.
And we have our gator shows on Saturday, and they're at 12 and 2.
Mm-hmm.
So in between then, Gator John will go in and bring out animals and do a little show in the Eco Lab, too.
Oh, that's nice. Cool. So you can learn a lot about them, too. Mm-hmm. I love that.
What other snakes do you have there in the exhibit?
We've got the boas, we have other pythons, corn snake, milk snake. There's all
one.
Other kinds in there.
It's a good one.
You look like an amazing snake charmer right now. It's incredible.
I somehow ended up with the most active one. Thanks, Jason.
Yeah, basically bracelets.
They are. They are very...
Dripping in diamonds? No. Dripping in snakes.
They are really pretty, though.
I mean,
they
are. Bar at Rusty's.
Like, I need a conversation piece, right? They are remarkable. Really, really cool. And I love the coloring. And you guys have live music, I know, going on seven days a week?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, at the
outside
restaurant there?
Tommy's, yep.
Okay, cool.
Awesome.
And all kinds of other stuff for the family to do.
So sweet.
Greg, are you sure this is your moment right here?
Nice. I already had my moment.
I mean, come on.
And it was for a good cause.
He's so nice.
He's. Mm-hmm.
I think
very
that was
sweet.
Probably the one you held.
Yeah, I think it was.
Was it?
Oh, he remembers you.
Aww.
That's okay. What time is it? Oh, it's 10:23. Before we went to break, last break, we asked, what did you want to be when you were a child? So conjure up those happy thoughts, and we'll be right back.
Snake charmer.